That we are interesting because we have a fantastic environment, we had a good team, we're a good club, and we are growing. So very happy that he want to join the ride and the journey, and looking forward to have him in the squad.
Is Brentford the place you think where he can secure himself as a week in, week out Premier League player?
I hope so. Of course, I have a few others that also can play centre-backs. So, in Christopher, Ben Mee, Ethan and Nathan. So there's good competition, but we need a strong squad. We saw that last year that we had a lot of injuries. We were unlucky. Some of it also, and definitely in the defensive side of it. We lost Sanka, so we need another one. And we always, when we sign one, depending of what we need, can we get a player in that can lift the bigger picture, the bigger level, plus have potential to grow? That's always the best, and I think we managed to get that in SEP.
And final question from me, Arne Slot's first home game in charge of Liverpool. You've got two new signings from Liverpool. I mean, can you just give us a sense of how you and the team are feeling heading into this?
Excited. We got a very good result against Crystal Palace. I think there was some very positive signs from that game in our performance. There was also some areas that we'd like to improve. We worked hard on trying to improve this week. We're going into a fantastic team against a good manager. Follow his work in Feyenoord, of course. Seen his pre-season games and, of course, the Ipswich game. And it looks good. He try to add layers to the fantastic job Klopp did. He inherited a fantastic team. I think maybe they just missed out. Was it the third or fourth last game of last season? They were basically toe-to-toe with Arsenal and City. And it's that team, more or less, that started against Ipswich, and it's a fantastic team. I saw some stats. We did some stats this morning to show about Liverpool. And at home, they are so frightening. And I expect them to be an unbelievable, difficult task. And they're huge favourites, of course, tomorrow. The flip side, we believe in ourselves and we know we have the capacity to go anywhere and try to win it. Most likely, you know, if you look at the odds, it's odds against. And Liverpool have a bigger chance of winning it. But we'll go there and do everything we can to try to do it.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Hi, Thomas. Can I just check the team news for this weekend?
Yeah. So in terms of, everyone should be available except the ones that that aren't. No, that that Justin Silva, Igor Thiago, Enrico, and Aaron. On that note, especially Rico is progressing very well, and hopefully he's soon ready to join the squad.
Fabio Carvalho is going to go back to Anfield. It's going to be a special day for him. Are you going to use his extra motivation for this match?
I'll say, Limpro, this one, he's definitely in the squad. He's a player. I said that before. Very excited that we have been able to sign him. I think he shows more and more. It's like any new player who's coming into a new team, it's still, even that he's easy to slot in because he's lived in the UK for a long time and know the Premier League and all that. He's taking the steps in the right direction, played a great in-house game, not in-house game, a game behind closed doors Tuesday. And it's looking better and better. So I'm very positive about him.
I want to ask you about the South American players from Liverpool, Luis Diaz, Darwin Núñez, Alexis Mac Allister. What do you think of them?
I think they are top players, and I think they are doing very well. I think we know Liverpool got a lot of threats, and I think their front three, no matter, of course, you say Salah is the standout, but I think Jota, Núñez and Diaz, Gakpo are really, really good players. And I think Diaz, I think when they signed him, it was like a player, of course, you knew about him, but he's impressed me with his pace. And his pace when he's carrying the ball forward and his ability to score goals. And McAllister, I thought, was a fantastic signing for them.
Just finally from me, how can you describe the atmosphere in Anfield for the fans around the world?
Probably others that can describe it even better than me, but of course, been privileged to be there three times when we played them. Yeah, of course, it's a special place. It's one of the cathedrals of football.
Anyone else like to do anything under immediate embargo? Yes, we'll go there and then 10. Yeah.
Yeah, in the match against Crystal Palace, you finished with less possession, but the majority of the duels won. How important will that be in the match?
I think it's important in any game. No matter if you have 70% possession or 30%, the duels are crucial. I don't know any manager, whether it's Guardiola or me or another one, that don't want the 50-50 duels to be won. It's crucial, and you get out on the right side of them, and preferably with the ball, and can play forward, hopefully. So that's going to be crucial. It's going to be a really tough game against a great team. In a great stadium, so we're really looking forward to it. We're excited about playing it. Never take anything for granted. It's our fourth season in the Premier League, and we look forward to play in an iconic place like this. One thing for sure, we need to be good on the ball, get good defending, be good in the duels, and a big thing, I think, to transitions both ways. Liverpool, I think, is maybe the best transition team in the world, especially offensively. So can we defend that well, and hopefully transition the other way, I think we'll have a chance.
Just wanted to start, with Henry. You obviously said he was progressing well. Is that a change from last week? Is that?
No, it's just on the right trajectory. He's trained every session here, full, no restrictions. So I just got a little bit more excited, and every single time he, you know, he's so electric, so he catch your eye quite easy. Just excited about it. And he is the... Has he been here as long as I? That's close to 8 years, yeah? Longer than me. Yeah, that's crazy. So I've been here close to 8 years, and he's the only one who's been here the whole time. So it's quite emotional to see him coming back, and I'm very, very pleased about it.
Is that full training?
Full training. Yeah. So this week, every session this week, he joined the full squad. Yeah.
And then I just wanted to start on Vandenberg. Obviously, you said in a previous press conference you wanted to play with a higher line this season. I'm assuming that Vandenberg's arrival, his pace, his ability in the air, those things factored in when you went and signed.
Yeah, definitely. I think he ticked a lot of boxes of what we are searching from our centre backs. I think he great pace, great to read the game, composed in on the ball, but also in decisive defensive actions. Good on the ball, and as you said, his abilities in the air is good as well. Of course, none of it is 10 out of 10, because then he will play for Madrid. But is in a good level at a good level. And with very good opportunity to develop it further. I see a great future for him.
And do you feel he's obviously spent a fair amount of money on him? Do you feel that he's ready to step into first team action?
I think he's ready. Of course, there's competition. I think, as I said, we have some very good other alternatives that done very well for us, either in a 3 or 4, from Christopher to Benmee. They had a fantastic first season, to Ethan Pinnock. It's been our standout centre back over the past 5 years, and then Nathan, I think, is taking the steps in the right direction, and I think Nathan had a great game against Crystal Palace. So there's competition, but there will always be competition, but I think if he hits his level, he will compete very, very good.
You put a lot of emphasis on characters when you bring players to the club. What have you looked at in Vandenberg's character that you've loved?
It's, you know, similar also to Fabio. We take references on them. It's very big for me that they are good people. And how do we check that? But of course, you speak to people in the environment. They are good characters that want to work hard, that want to learn, that want to reflect, that want to progress. They think of the team. So one of our biggest values is togetherness. So they need to know that we can only achieve something big if we go together.
Will he be registered in time for Sunday, or is that for
game? I think so. I haven't anything else. Should be.
So he'll be involved in the squad in Sunday.
He should be able for... He is definitely... It's possible he'll be involved, yeah. I had to word that correctly.
Obviously, this is your second signing of the summer, but it's your second signing from Liverpool. Have you looked at Liverpool as a club and the way that they're producing players and Is that something that you've looked at, basically? Why do you like that?
I like Liverpool as a club. I think they've done very well over the last many, many years, of course. But I think the development they had, I think it's fair to say, since Klopp came in, there's a lot of other people that's behind the scenes that did the job in that spell of 8-9 years. I think they've developed some great players, but it's not because it's from Liverpool. I think it's two players we liked, Fabio and Sepp, and we thought they could add quality to our squad, and it was possible financially. So, yeah.
I didn't quite catch up. It might have been asked, but is Carvalho also, he will be involved?
Yeah, he will be involved, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Yes.
Hi.
It's going to be a huge crowd. How do you manage your nerves, if you've got any?
It's taken.
How do you manage your nerves? It's going to be a huge crowd, if you've got any.
On Sunday? I think that, of course, there will always be a few nerves or butterflies, always exciting when you go into a game. And when you go to a fantastic away ground as Anfield, you feel something. But I think the experience over time, it makes it more normal, standard. Butterflies or nerves or excitement about a game that I've learned to control okay, depending on how it goes during the game. But just looking forward to it.
Yep.
Hi, Thomas. You briefly touched upon Vandenberg's qualities, but when I was doing some research into him, one thing I noticed was he scored 3 goals in the Premier League last season, which is more than each of Brentford's centre-backs in the Premier League.
Last season?
Yeah, I think the most was Pinnock with 2, same colleagues. Is goal scoring ability something that you look for in a centre back? Because when you rewatch Wiss's goal at weekend, both Collins and Pinnock were in the area.
Yeah, definitely. I think you need to get a certain amount of goals out of your squad or your team. And of course, you always want the front 2 or front 3 to score a lot of them. But can you add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 from a centre back? It's invaluable. It's fantastic, and everyone knows that we are good on set pieces. We put focus on it. So when we put focus on it, we need someone who's able to actually hit the ball into the back of the net. And definitely, that's some of Sepp's qualities. I think he's good at it. I think he can improve even more, but I think he's got good potential there and good timing. You said that with a goal is like a second phase after a long throw, where we are brave and keep players up. That makes it difficult for the defenders to defend.
Okay, if you don't mind me asking, what is the typical target for centre back goals in a season?
Oof. I've never thought there's a typical one. I think, as you said, 3 probably. I don't think you find many centre backs in Premier League that score 3 goals a season. So if all our centre backs can do that, that'll be good. As I said, if I name 5, okay, that's 15 goals. That's not bad. Of course, not all of them will start at the same time, but 3 will be a good number. 4 will be fantastic. 5 through the roof.
So what you're saying is your current centre backs are underperforming in terms of that.
I think the second year, I think the first year in the Premier League, I think Poncho scored 3. I think Ethan scored 2 or 3. Second year, Ethan was up around 3. We actually did a nice stat, so here you can have it. So last 3 seasons in the Premier League, we have scored the most goals by centre-backs in the Premier League. So we're doing quite well.
See, I didn't actually know that.
So check on that. 20 goals, yeah. Second on the list, I can't remember who it was, they scored 18, there was 16, 15, so we're doing okay.
I know you're not really one to concern about how much the club spends on a player, but if you kind of take a step back and put kind of your football purist views on, is our transfer fee less of a representation about their current ability and more about a hypothesis of what they could become?
I guess it depends a little bit on the age. So, of course, let's say Sepp and Fabio are two young players. There's definitely, they have already done well, but Fabio haven't played that much the last 2 years. So that's probably on potential. Sepp played more, but I agree, depending on where you cut it, something it's definitely something with the potential, definitely. And it seems like clubs are buying younger and younger, and it's getting more and more expensive.
And one final thing from me. So Sepp's 22, Nathan's 23, Chris is 26, you've got Ethan at 31 and Ben at 34. Do you think you've got the perfect balance of youth and experience in that area?
Yeah, I think actually I think it's a very good balance, no doubt about that. And I think the experience of Ethan and especially Ben is fantastic to give to the squad, and that helps massively. And then we got two, as you said, very young centre backs with great potential, and Chris is in the middle with a great still rising, I think, and he's like a. Also a player that can play outside of the three and fullback position. So I'm happy with that.
Brilliant, thank you.
Welcome.
One at the back and then we'll start the embargoed sections.
So thanks, I'm so involved. Just want to ask with the two new Liverpool signings, how desperate are they to play and get one over against their old team?
I haven't asked them about that. but I think first and foremost they are excited about coming and joining us, and they, I could imagine, both of them just badly want to start the first game for us. I have great expectations for them, and I'm really excited about both of them, and I'm sure they will be a big asset for us. If they will start on Sunday, we'll see on Sunday.
From the time that Toney was out of the team, did you sort of think that the rest of the players to step up and maybe make yourselves all
rounded
as a team, if that's the
case now? Yeah, I think, you know, depending on the players who are playing, even that you want to play a certain style, their personal trademarks, of course, affect the style a bit. And of course, Ivan have some fantastic abilities that take the style in a little one direction, and Wizard got some trademark abilities that go a little bit other direction. So style of player, the things we want is the same. I would say it hasn't changed too much. But of course, Ivan has been a fantastic player for us. And we need to find a different way to still score a lot of goals, which we have managed to do.
I realize I'm part of the problem by asking this, but are you sick and tired of questions about Toney's future?
Yes.